breathing, I just can't help myself. Yeah, you're looking at me like she no good for my health. And I know now that I came here with someone else. So I regret and I just can't help myself. Pick or choose.
We don't know, because we haven't flipped the coin.
You know all I'm thinking about is you. And this weather feels like we can do something together, no pressure. We just take a break and step away from the crowd.
Welcome.
Maybe I show. It's 100 degrees and I just can't help myself.
Team Jirachi! Riley, are you here?
Do what? Oh, coin toss?
Okay.
Do we go down first? Yeah, go down on me and just like talk to the team real quick. Who approved Gio?
Distracting has me feeling kinda counterfeit.
I guess nobody else signed up.
To be honest, I'm not good at letting down my guard, but I really want it. Before you, I was running in the dark. When you said this was goodbye, that's when I realized I can't live without, I can't live without you. I want you and only you. I got nothing left to to be honest, I'm not good at letting down my guard, but I really want it. Before you, I was running in the dark. When you said this was goodbye, that's when I realized I can't live without, I can't live without you. I want you and only you. I want you and only you.
What is up, everybody? Welcome to Find Me Alpha LCS, social distancing split of the century. With me on cast today is StarCraft.
Hello.
And we are casting one of the most epic games, Teamwork Tonic versus Imagine If We Had a Real Support. Captain is OG Juice Man for Teamwork Tonic and Jirachi for Imagine If We Had a Real Support. And we are getting into Champion Select. We're already halfway through it. I actually have the names wrong. Let me swap those around. There we go. I'm a pro streamer. You can see me move my assets around. Let's just get right into the analysis here for pick and ban. So we see three jungle targeted bans from IRS, and a Senna, a Sylas, and a Kayn from TWT, and that first pick, Rakan. So what are your thoughts on those picks right now, StarCraft? Where do you think IRS is trying to go with their comp, and what's TWT scared of?
I mean, obviously TWT is just very afraid of Geo. IRS is afraid of Geo just kind of getting whatever champion he wants. Those are his three big picks he's been playing on. We've seen instant Caitlyn pick from TWT as well to take that away. Actually, do you still have the names flipped?
No, they're right. No.
Okay, cool. So yeah, the Caitlyn away from Jirachi. That's really smart. Pretty much taking the two best AD carries that Jirachi has right there. Leona, interesting pick against the Rakan. It's kind of hard. I guess they're going to try to use it more of a counter-engage sort of thing. And Sivir picked instantly as well. It is technically a counter to Caitlyn.
Yeah.
Outranger with that Q every time she comes up to you.
She does a good job into the Leona as well, being able to spell shield the stun. Plays pretty well around that. Pretty well around just the other things that Leona likes to do. So overall, I think that's a good pick. I kind of would have liked to see maybe just the Morgana with the Caitlyn, but it might not be in their supports wheelhouse because, it's not the most meta of champs right now. I mean, it's getting up there, but tanks were most recently the most meta for the season, so...
Well, it's also, it's your boy, so taking his comfort Rakan pick away, I think he knows the way that Leona works into it.
Mm-hmm.
Then IRS actually picking the Sejuani here. Makes sense. Neil the Steel played that a lot last split. And then another big boy tank getting picked up by TWT. They're hovering over Zac. I do like the Zac pick a lot. They're playing a Protect the Caitlyn comp if they do that. Then Moo Egg Boy would have to pick something with a lot of damage mid. But yeah, I think they've definitely got to pick jungle here, or they're going to start banning some more.
Yeah, I think they've got a lot of really good engage already on the side of TWT. Looking forward to kind of seeing how that plays out in terms of just the game in general. And what they're looking to take away. So we see the Zoe ban from TWT as well. And a couple Bruisery top laners are gone, as well as Wukong, who's a little bit overpowered right now.
Very surprised if they don't ban Ryzer. Wow, Skiz actually plays an insane Ryze.
Yeah, I mean, I'd like to see maybe a Ryze pick. It could be good. I'm interested to see what the mid matchup's gonna be, because everyone's just picked, okay, mm-hmm. Galio mid. So this is where I would pick a Kassadin, typically, or some sort of hard scaling the Ryze, some sort of hard scaling mid.
Well, yeah, I think they've just done nothing really to stop him or dissuade him from picking Ryze here. I mean, the Galio does counter it, but you can match him roam for roam with your ult as well.
When
my team played against Skiz in Clash, he was, or in, what was it, in the Elder Cup, he's averaging about 9 CS a minute. So Vladimir, it is a flex pick here. They've got, who's their top laner? Yeah, OJ Juice Man. So both of them could play it.
Is that the spicy new Volibear? I'm into it. I've seen that champ. That champ looks really good.
It looks cool. I don't know if good is the right word for it.
Okay, no. They're meaning. No one has enough experience on the champ yet. I think it looks sweet, but...
It's very simple, but orange is better.
Yeah, orange is better in the team fight context, especially when you pick a Vladimir in your other solo lane. He just provides all the CC you need, really. So something to note, though, that's only like, I feel like they could have gone with maybe another melee. I guess, does Rakan count as melee in terms of Sejuani procs?
I mean, the auto attack range is very short, but basically you're not going to be autoing anyway, so it's all just about the abilities. I wouldn't even call Recon melee because of the W's range.
Yeah. I was just curious just because of the way that Sejuani interacts, so... Mm-hmm. Like, it would be maybe, like, maybe a Nautilus pick there, because you're not picking Rakan in a Nautilus.
They just pick Rakan 100%, so Itchy Void doesn't get the chance to pick it.
Oh, yeah, I know.
Both these teams are very strange to me. One of them, we literally have four tanks on the side of TWT. They're putting all their eggs on the Caitlyn basket.
AP Zac jungle.
I guess. It could be some ridiculous Zac top or something, but... Yeah, just super AP damage on both sides here. We've got a Sivir on IRF, which is more of a utility support. They're just trying to run down Caitlyn.
Yeah, so we can rewatch this as we kind of discuss. I think that the Caitlyn, yeah, it's gonna get caught, right? It has to by the Ornn or Sedge.
Yeah, because they don't have like a Braum or something, which I would have actually really liked to see.
Yeah, Braum support. And the Sivir's really strong. I mean, it's kind of awkward when you look at it. Just TWT, they're looking to kind of, I think, scale up with the tanks that they have and the potential for Caitlyn damage. Because Galio's no slouch either. Galio does enough damage to like deal with the Sivir, maybe.
True.
But I think the tank matchup for IRS is just slightly better. With the Vladimir and the Vlad ult, and then Sivir's ability to kind of shred multiple champions at once.
Oh yeah, I think if the side of IRS, if they front to back, I think they win very easily, because I don't know if Caitlyn can actually get in range to do the damage to the priority target, which is just Sivir. Like, well, I think Sivir's going to be super safe back there, with Rakan to fear people, with a Sejuani to peel, with an Ornn to ult, the front and back line. Zac's going to jump in, but I don't know if they have enough damage from TWT to finish fights off.
They also made it a little bit awkward to buy like Grievous Wounds into IRS's composition, just because the only person that really relies on the healing is Vladimir. I mean, Rakan does it a little bit, but you're buying it for Vladimir at that point. So it's one champion. It's not going to be as efficient in terms of armor pen against Sedge Ornn. So it could lead to just these awkward exchanges. Honestly, TWT, I would have liked to see, once they pick up the Sedge, to pick up maybe a more auto-attack oriented jungle that can do stuff like Trundle does, but just, you know, maybe like a tankier Jax version.
Yeah, I think a Warwick would have been a really good pick there.
A Warwick, yeah.
Yeah, Warwick's very, very strong right now.
The Zac feels just a little bit redundant with what you have going on with Leona. And it's kind of the same thing with Maokai for me. I would have maybe liked to see a Bruiser going into the Ornn. Yeah. Like Zac or like a
I think that Juiceman plays Darius. I think that would have been a really good pick, actually. Because there's not anyone on the side of IRS that super punishes a Darius for being short ranged.
Right. Yeah. No. In fact, it's really good just because.
Yeah. Into Vlad, into Ornn.
Sivir's short range. It has a lot of bleed. Yeah. And potential to like build into Thornmail to stop that Vladimir from healing up. I mean, it. Yeah, I feel very awkward about these picks. I don't think the comps are super optimal for what they want to do. I like IRS's personally a little bit better, just because they
I think it's a little bit easier to pull off just because of the Ornn and the Sejuani.
Well, right, and you're running Sivir, right? You press R, you win.
Well, you just press W, I think, in these team fights. And there's going to be four priority melee targets in front of you.
That's true. Yeah, no, I think it's just TWT's comp is a little bit awkward for me. But I see a world where they win, too, just off of scale. Like, if the Caitlyn's able to win the lane with Leona, right? Which she should be able to do against Rakan in the support matchup, just flat out. And the ADC matchup is pretty Caitlyn-favored as well. If Sivir plays it right, she could do, like... She could start wave-clearing harder than Caitlyn does and poking out more. But I feel like the bot lane matchup is TWT favored, and Zac's probably going to be focusing down there as well. So if Zac's able to focus there, they gain a lead, and they keep their tanks safe. You know, I see a world where they team fight well, and just are able to win it before Vladimir really comes online in the later stages of the game.
Yeah, I think the plan B for TWT as well, they have a very easy way to put advanced wards, and then with the range of Zac to slingshot onto the enemy team.
Right.
Without getting punished super hard, really, because, I mean, it's going to take forever for IRS to kill a Zac. Zac builds Spirit Visage and his jungle item, and
then Sivir has to get in range to auto attack him.
Yeah, so it's just... gonna be. I mean, they have the CC to like stop him from doing a lot, but like with the Sejuani, but a lot of their CC and the Rakan, it's a little bit conditional beyond Sejuani's dash and Rakan's W. And just like, so the melee autos, I only see Sej and Orin that can really contribute, unless I'm wrong and Rakan can do that. Because I think he's ranged, but I'm really not sure.
Yeah, he's ranged.
He's ranged. Okay, because yeah. I was like, I haven't seen a Tiamat Rakan.
Nah.
But I think I've seen Rudan's Rakan. So, just to explain the type of League of Legends that I like to play. And... so only two melees with Sej makes the stun really awkward, potentially to land. The Ornn stuff is always kind of awkward to land unless you're doing it as follow-up. So it's really going to be on Rakan and Sej to kind of hold their CC, whereas TWT, they have super reliable forms of CC and follow-up, but that's all they have is, like, CC. They have four CC bots and a Caitlyn to deal damage, so... I'd like to maybe see a more AP-heavy Zac and Galio build this game, like building Liandry's on both of them, especially when you're up against Ornn, Sej, Vlad.
Well, Galio is gonna... I don't know about Liandry's. Usually the typical build is to go Protobell into, like, Morellos.
Well, yeah, and I can see Morello, same purpose. Too.
You're gonna have to go Morellos against Vlad. It's
right.
That's I think Vlad will be more of a saving grace than Sivir in these teamfights, honestly, because it's gonna be just constant rotations of his abilities.
Right, and I agree, Morello is probably the priority for both of them. Well, maybe not for Zac. Yeah. Zac really likes Liandry's. But I think on Galio in the mid lane, you're going to be going for that heal cut as soon as you can, second item, and dealing with the Vlad, you know, the best that you can. But then I think those two are going to be mainly dealing with the tanks in Vladimir. I think at that point... you're trying to have, you know, Leona Maokai CC the Sivir, and if you have damage on your Zac Galio, you're pretty much good.
Yeah, so we've got about 30 seconds left until we get into the game. So last time asking you, Nate, which side you got? You got IRS or TWT?
I got IRS. I think they have the easier comp, the faster comp. They have the speed. So if TWT pulls it out, it'll be through bot lane, and it'll be, you know, through the build that they have to take. What do you think?
I'm gonna have to agree. I think IRS's comp, as we stated a little bit earlier, it's just a little bit easier to pull off. They've got more options in case they mess up the initial one. Like, they've got Ornn, they've got Sej, they've got Rakan pretty much twice because of his jump and because of his ult. I think we go past 35 minutes, and if there's not a Dragon Soul like looming over on the side of TWT, it's going to be very problematic for them. It's going to be really hard for them to finish the game out. All right, so I am in... you want to pause it like 5 seconds or something after it loads? All right. What time are you at? Hey there. Okay, I think your stream crashed.
I think we should be good now. Yeah, we're live.
Okay, tell me what time you're at, and then I'll pause.
135, 36, 37.
Right, I'll wait. Stop at 43.
Okay. Okay, I'm at 49. Right. Can you just push forward?
Yeah, give me a second.
Sorry, guys.
I'm gonna... All right, give me a countdown, then I'll hit start again.
3, 2, 1. Boom. All right, we're back. Sorry about that. Everyone had to give it a give the old chair stream the XQC special.
Not bad. So we got pretty standard starts here. No crazy items or runes, really. I mean, everybody just uses pro builds now. It's a boring game that we live in.
I know, nothing, no spice.
So we've got, they're pretty much gonna be mirroring each other's jungles here. We started from red side for Sejuani. Sejuani actually surprisingly ran straight to double buff pre-level 3, which I don't really see the huge advantage of as a Sejuani. It's not like you're really gonna get anything out of it. You still are gonna need to get level 3 before an efficient gank.
I think that you could maybe see a counter gank towards. I don't know.
Looks like they're both heading topside right now.
They're both heading topside.
Oh, they're getting the bot side right now. Your boy jumps onto Jirachi. Maybe just got a little bit of scuffle in the bot side.
Look at topside jungle right now. Mm-hmm. We're an invaded.
Yeah, smart ward.
Got the good ward out. And here's a big level 3 gank mid lane. Boom.
So yeah, Galio's gonna walk up towards that top bush. Gets knocked up by Needle Steel. No Steel procs the aftershock. He's got the taunt, but he's not doing any damage. That's just flashback over to this tower. It's a flash burn for free right there from Galio.
It was really close. I mean, you're also looking at Maokai winning trades. Let me fix the layout here.
Well, Maokai will win it initially, but look at the mana differential. Guy Fury has full mana here. And Guy Fury's actually going to try to jump in. Misses the E, though. Gets a knockup from his W. The slow from Needle Steel. Flash very late from OG Juice Man, and First Blood goes over to Sejuani.
And that's a really just heads-up play from Sej, knowing that, you know, you're in your melee lane, the wave is bouncing back towards your Ornn, so it just was a very good, very smart gank there.
Yeah, and Ornn, Galio wasted all of his mana early to spam a lot of those Qs to try to get harassment in the lane, but not really doing any damage to Ornn. They just stuck there with no mana, so he couldn't W to either of them to proc his aftershock, just kind of chucked walking away.
Maokai was just a little bit out of luck there as far as... Mm-hmm.
We've got both junglers here in the mid lane right now. Needle Steel is actually caught out of position. Skiz gets hit up, has to pull away, out to Flash as well. Returning onto Needle. Needle is fairly tanky though, he's taking down about half health. He wants to turn it looks like, but Skiz is not in range yet for a Q. A flash from Needle gets the stun onto Galio. Nice cleanup right there by Vladimir with the Q. That's just really experience from Neil knowing Sejuani, knowing if I flash here, even though I just threw out my W, I'm gonna hit him with Q, I'm gonna stun him.
Mm-hmm. I mean, these are actually some crazy close fights that are happening in the mid lane, and just like it worked out really well. Ah, PMA.
Oh, yeah, they paused because we weren't there. Well, they paused because we weren't there.
Wait, what?
So you were gone, and then the stream pretty much crashed on itself.
Oh,
you were all tabbed.
Yeah, no, I didn't. I had to use the bathroom, and it didn't automatically change screen. So, sorry guys, this pause is on me.
It's alright. They paused for like 20 seconds, maybe. And
okay.
Was okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
I never thought I would be the cause as a streamer to cause a pause in game. I thought most people in game just did not even care. Okay, we've used up 20 seconds of the streamer pause times. So that is an incoming ban loss. For my next team that I'm on in PMA LCS. Big engage from Titsy Boy. Jirachi having to flash away. Oh man. That's a
huge
flash. Yeah.
Oh, it's your boy. Yeah, with another Q on it. Very awkward positioning though. Neil's looking to kind of steal the health again.
Solid flash from Titsy Boy. Zach's just a little bit late on the counter ganks. Coming in, it would be working out better if he was ignoring his camps a little bit more. But the interesting thing is, you look at blue side; they already have wards in that tribe,
all over the...
where Zac could even be. So they knew not to even chase. They saw the Zac and they backed off. They were like, "Okay, we got flash. That's what we want."
Well, they know against Zac, you've got to ward those bushes because it's pretty much pointless to ward your river towards the lane.
Right. And you're going to see Jaundice here just recalling
just
on a
standing
ward.
On a ward unknowingly, yeah.
Yeah, and he doesn't have the opportunity. They could maybe even bait this, like, I don't know. They did.
They already recalled. Yeah, he was sitting on gold there.
Yeah. Like, sometimes you got to maximize getting those awkward backs off from the jungle, but...
Got a permafish going on top here. It's again, though, Jujutsu Man's out of mana. I'd be interested to look back at the VOD to see what happened. I think he's just.
I think he's just,
way too much to try to answer him.
Yeah, I think he's queuing waves, I would imagine. Mm-hmm. I mean, I can look around, but.
Well, it's going to be really hard because he's going to go with Missile Mask first, especially against a team with four AP champions.
Yeah.
It's going to give Ornn sustain forever in that lane. Let's slow down for a second here. We can kind of look at the CS. As to be expected, Caitlyn's a little bit up in CS, about 11. The
yeah.
gold mid, what happened after that first blood? So about 400 gold advantage on Vlad right there. Jujutsu is getting bullied even more here by Ornn.
And we're kind of
I think he's asking for a counter gank, but they couldn't have been 2v1 him.
I don't think they can do much because Ornn is just Ornn, you know? He does.
Yeah.
He has shields, he has CC, he has an escape, he has a dash to escape, so unless Guy Fieri blows that dash for some reason. I don't really see a gank being too fruitful here.
They also said that under overlay, the team names are still backwards.
Oh, my bad, guys. Sorry. I'll do my pro streamer strat. There we go.
Alright, there we go. Problem solved.
Problem solved. I know, I had him set up for red side, and I had him set up for the opposite sides before the match. And then 4 minutes before stream, they flip the coin and tell me, oh, it's the other
so
side.
So Zach's going in here, but yeah, even with the knockup? Yeah,
Ornn
Guy Fieri's trying to turn
kill.
The fight because look how much damage. It's just no damage at all being done on Ornn. And both TPs are coming out from the mid laner. It's going to be a rumble in the top lane here.
Ornn's out.
Just kidding. Everybody just says hi and walks away.
Yeah.
Could have been worse. But yeah, it's, like we were saying, we literally predicted the future like 45 seconds ago. We were like, the gate's not going to do anything here.
Yeah, it just didn't look very good. And this is a solid play from Yelva Steel, seeing Zac top, seeing their mid laner go top, and the bot lane's pushed in off of Sivir's mana. I mean,
it's just completely free dragon.
Absolutely free. Really heads up. They're winning across the map now because Ornn was able to turn. They also got Galio's TP, which kind of felt like it didn't need to be used.
Yeah, I guess they thought the fight would go on longer than that. And they're actually, Murphy brought it gesturing forward. I don't think that would have actually hit. But just a safe flash from So Reckless anyway.
Yeah.
They're cutting it backwards. And here comes the ult from Sejuani. They're frozen solid, but no damage to follow up.
So yeah,
they actually blow just one ult there. Oh, Caitlyn. Sivir.
Missed time on the Sivir.
Galio's looking for an ult here, but I don't think they're going to stay.
No. I mean, it's a half health bot lane now. So honestly, they should be looking to push him back, but they didn't see mid for a little bit.
Oh.
So it looks like they're kind of coming up.
Well, John's looking for a lane gank, but there's actually a ward in that far bottom brush right there that would see him if he walks any closer.
Yeah, and I bet he doesn't know about it.
Definitely not. They've been shoved for so long
I mean,
just great
boy
control.
Is six. Has the ultimate available. So there could be a play there where, Leona ults and then Zac jumps in.
Well, it's just so hard because Sivir has spell shield still, so the initial solo flare is not going to do very much.
That plays over. The spot already happened, and now it's just some wet noodles in the top lane just slapping each other.
Oh, man.
I'd almost argue that, you see what OG Juice Man's doing here. He's throwing all of his abilities at the wave. Ornn has W.
Guy Fieri's tanks 4-5 tower shots. Oh. Has to flash away. Clash more Juice Man. His W will be back up in about 5 seconds. Oh, the E away from Guy Fieri. He should survive here with the Ocean Drake, with the regen.
I'm going to say it. Ornn is so broken, dude.
Wait a minute.
No,
look at that.
Ornn
baits him yet again. Ocean Juice Man has no mana. I don't know if Sejuani had to flash there, but Style Points is going to go to Neil the Steel. Juice Man. There's such overkill. Just kill him.
And his suffering.
Yeah,
like
no flash, no mana, Maokai. Just hits them with the horn. They just ping that Rift Herald as well.
Zac has the right idea, like staying towards bottom side here, because obviously I think the Ornn is just going to be in a winning matchup against...
Well, it's the only lane ahead right now, too.
Right. It's the only lane you can really, really do much in.
Oh, Moo Eggboy goes back into Skid. Skid still has that pool, though. If he can get one more jump. Yeah, he jumps in.
Oh,
great flash by Skid.
I feel like Skiz there should not have been walking up. I mean, it kind of needlessly blew Splash because you're Vladimir. Like, it's one of those things where you just got to think about what's my champion going to do here versus Galio. If Galio gets his cooldowns back, I'm screwed. But if I sit here and farm and press Q and heal to health, I can tank it and then win the trade. Galio doesn't have that sort of regen, so just a little minor thing where it ends up costing him a flash because he doesn't like think about the sustain. And he just thinks about, I want the kill. My cooldowns are almost up.
Yeah, it's very hard. You have to outplay so hard or have such a mistake from the enemy to even have a chance of killing Gleb.
Right. And that's one of the things. He's opened himself up to the opportunity of getting ganked now with his flash down and against a high CC opponent in the mid lane. So I'd be looking mid if I were Jaundice right now, just for Vladimir to walk back in the lane and then just either insta kill him, or end up transitioning to bot. Mm-hmm. Because
for the side of TWT, mm-hmm. Leona finally punished the enemy for deboarding there. Got about an extra 50 gold just from pinking and clearing vision in their own blue side. So now it opens up the opportunity for Zac to gank in the only lane that is ahead.
True. I mean, the vision, though, from IRS is just kind of overwhelming. Looking at bottom side, that whole river's lit up with controls.
Mm-hmm. Just like you were calling it. Here comes the gank to the mid lane. Skiz gets taunted up. They don't have very much damage. Jaundice is walking in circles now, waiting for Sejuani. Here comes Sejuani from the wings. Throws the ult out as kind of a saving grace. Skiz gets away with a slither of health. Oh my god, gets that last Q, and this is a disaster for TWT.
Man, TWT was so close on that. I feel like if Jaundice knew there wasn't a flash on Skiz, he would have just had that sliver of extra damage from an auto that would have secured the kill.
And the Richard's gonna drop down here, so it's just a good gank. It's just been turned on its head now. It's gonna be at least four platings here, probably the first tower. Yeah, just zoning Jaundice out. Skiz is going a little insane here.
Oh my god.
But the pull up as well, yeah, it's just that mastery of that champion.
Yeah, Skiz really showing off there, just trying to tilt Jaundice, take its passive away. Mm-hmm. Getting the mid tower. I mean, mid tower is almost dead. So
the Jaundice does get back in there because that regen on the passive is insane.
Yeah.
Sejuani is out of mana if they overstay. I doubt they will, though, because Skiz is sitting on...
I think Skiz can win this pretty easily.
Jaundice is just walking towards him. Oh, he's trying to bait for the Galio ult.
Oh, interesting. But he's already dead.
Skiz should die as well, though. Wait a minute. Neil with the bluff. Oh, Neil steals the kill away from Mu Egg Boy. And now Skiz is just going to regen. Oh my god, this Vlad refuses to die.
Oh,
that was
that's
a beautiful body block. All the way down for...
He's
going to clean up... Nice. It's too good.
That support room
for so long.
That support room might have saved the game. I'm gonna be honest.
Two hit shutdowns. About like 1,200 gold off of all of that right there.
1,200 gold, a kill and an assist on the Galio and Leona.
And
so getting
plates
the bot
too.
Lane further ahead, more plates. Like Galio really needs the gold in this matchup.
Mm-hmm. Galio might die to the tower here. Careful. Super close.
So that's huge that they ended up. Being able to,
was an absurd like 2 minutes of events right there, all just off of one gank.
One really long gank.
So much was blown in there. Never know with the two shutdowns. It's now a 3,000 gold advantage for IRS though, so it didn't really change very much. And dragon's coming up. Blue team just took the first tower. Now their whole team is rotating 4v2 down to dragon side. They're caught out of position
special.
Here as well.
This is the special right here. I'm ready.
Skiz is just running straight at him. Skiz is going to do so much damage. Dragon pulls super early, actually. Could get CC. Muekboy needs to be careful. It's still a 4v3, as I just stated earlier. They didn't see the Sivir coming from the wings. The Sivir ult will just speed up now. Muekboy doesn't get a kill in the support, but now the damage dealers are showing their size here. One kill down, two, three are killed. And Zac is going to try to jump in to save his tower. But it's been a 3-for-1 in a very easy trade for IRS. Yeah, they're going to die, but they know that Zac doesn't have a passive. Zac smartly ults away, is getting flashed down on. It's gonna get away with a little bit of his health. The frog wants a little bit of the action too. God, 3-for-1, it's gonna be dragon as well. Smite is up in about not too long on Sejuani. They're just gonna start it up.
What time are you at? I think we got desynced a little bit. I'm 15, 15,
I'm at
16, 16,
17.
Okay, we're about right. I had to fast forward.
Yeah.
It's Zach's fine. Skiing in for this.
Zach's looking for the steal here. Does the flyover. Gets knocked up. Oh, he does get the steal from a level behind.
Huge.
So I don't know if Sejuani's smite came up or not. Actually, it just came up. I saw it tick, so it was like a second or two away. So that's rough. They've got to stop DPSing in that situation.
That's the ballsy play that I like to see from Jonathan. Mm-hmm. Like, he knows he's behind, but he doesn't care. He just is like, I'm going for it.
Well, I'm hoping that someone on the side of TWT said, hey, I got smited bottom when Sejuani ulted us. Like, they don't have it up for Dragon right now. That's what I'd like to think, but I think Jonas is kind of throwing a Hail Mary there as their team falls down about 5,000 gold.
Right, and that dragon just staves off one of the win cons for IRS. So now it's what is it, Mountain Drag that's coming up? Mountain Rift?
We'll see in a second here. The train hasn't changed yet. So.
Oh, okay. I think what is this called? The
spectator client still bugged for that?
The objective timer is displaying a mountain.
Okay.
Yeah, and I think it is because I think I see the extra terrain.
Gotcha.
So, Mountain Drag is actually very huge for TWT.
It's huge for both teams. They have three tanks on each team. Skiz is just going fearless right now, running straight into three enemies. He knows that they don't have the damage. Nobody has Grievous Wounds yet. Yeah. Wow. Skiz and Nature Boy are just kind of wheeling their way around the enemy team. I don't think anyone will die, but it's kind of demoralizing, honestly, from the side of TWT.
League of Health?
How did you speak so afraid? Of two tanks and a Vlad, he just flashes away even with a Spirit Visage.
League of Health Resident Sleeper, like... get some Assassins in here, give me Kog'Maw. Like, these tanks are just battling each other and just nothing is happening. No health bars are moving. It's just three tanks versus three tanks.
I can't wait to do the damage charts after this game. It's gonna be absurd for Vlad and Galio.
Yeah, Vlad and Galio are gonna enjoy it. I mean, Galio, yeah. Let's take a second here and just look at the completed items. Mm-hmm. So we see MR coming out from both top laners. Looks like a little bit ahead on the orange.
Oh, Jonas, sorry to cut you off. Jonas is jumping straight into four people here. We've got Luna going as well. A flash away from Drachi to keep that damage going on. The front line is getting knocked down now by Sivir. The damage has not yet come for the side of them, but your boy's getting it. The AoE is working in the favor of TWT, even though they're behind. They caught them off guard from Rip. Now Reckless is finally here, and the team already won the fight without him. And Neela Seal is trying to get a kill, but Sacrifice just has to honestly walk up on them. You're full health, you need to come DPS them, because Ornn did not join that fight.
Yeah, Ornn just prioritized bot tower there, which I feel like...
That wasn't a good ward, really, from the TP, too.
Yeah, he could TP behind them into,
Mm-hmm. There's a pink ward in their own red, yeah.
Yeah, so I think so one of those wards would have been good to TP to, but ends up opting for the objective, which I can't say that's wrong, but I feel like they could have probably gotten all five if Ornn showed up. But maybe they would have gotten one less tower. So split push looks pretty good.
The problem too is that even though they won that fight technically, they actually lost three people for two in that, you know? It was a 5v4, right. And both teams traded two people. They lost the bottom tower and the top inner turret for the Rift. Because look at the gold difference. It's almost 8,000 in that one. Before the fight, it was at 6,000.
Right. So IRS is just maximizing, I think, what they can do as far as gold and pressure on the map. Because Ornn is very safe there. He knows no one's going to do anything to me. I can just clear this way behind tower, smack this thing up, get it. Do it all while his team is able to go fairly even honestly in a fight.
Yeah, and he's two levels up on Maokai right now, so when he does join a fight with this next TP he has, it's gonna be insanely hard to kill him.
Yeah, he's already big. I mean, he has two.
He's got
two ornified items. Yeah. Wait, did I see an activated ability happen on his Sunfire Cape?
That's how it works now. It pops every few seconds and then. It doesn't. When they buff Sunfire Cape, it does an extra pop damage. It's 100 damage every 12 seconds, yeah. Oh, Leona actually whiffs the ult there, but still goes in and has so much CC. They're trying to catch Sivir as hard as they can. Sivir is still as health. The Redemption brings him back to about quarter health as well. The two tanks are chasing down the Sivir. They want this kill so bad that they're going under the enemy tower without any of their damage dealers. And like I was talking about, here comes the Ornn. He's going to clean it off. He misses the ult. It doesn't matter because he has so much damage. Double kill to the Ornn. The fight's going to keep going on. Caitlyn throws the ult out but does nothing. Now that the cleanup is going to be super easy, I think, for the side of IRS. Look at that. Three beefy boys are just beating up this one tree. Oh, the double kill turned though with the regeneration from the passive. Guy wants to come back in. This fight is insane. Can Caitlyn get away to get the DPS going? The tanks want Caitlyn so bad. Neolithiel is trying to flash away. Look at that. Now Fury is still going for Caitlyn. He's in E range. It's not yet going to happen. This is just super messy, crazy skirmishes all around here for this.
Oh my
and then
God.
At the end of it all, it was a 2-for-3.
Percent health
damage. Boy just
kind of
gets caught, has to flash away. Might actually survive with that flash. It's a pretty good one. Oh, the golden chicken.
He's dead.
Yep, looks like he's still going down there.
Wow. I mean, Ornn is full health. That's how I'm going to describe that fight. Ornn is full health.
That's just so rough, because if Ornn would have hit that ult sooner, he could have gotten the double kill and turned and helped his teammates
out.
Yeah,
he got stunned out by the Leona, which messed up the timing.
Yeah, it was a very smart stun. Well, Ornn's actually caught out a little bit here, but again, it's just two tanks doing nothing.
Ornn doesn't get caught out.
So much damage with that W, yeah.
Ornn does the catching.
Ornn tricks the catching. And oh, really skillful jump over there with Rakan to get on top of Zac. Nice. Zac has to run away with only about 400 health left, and the dragon is up. This would be the second dragon for the side of IRS.
Ornn was 2v1, and Ornn is basically full health.
Well, yeah, we were talking about itemization before. They had a crazy like 5 minutes of fighting. I haven't caught my breath since then.
Yeah.
But we're saying that there's Ember on both sides of top. I think in a game like this, as they start the dragon, it's going to be picked up though from IRS. But in a game like this, where it's so much magic damage, we kept talking about that over and over. Abyssal Mask is a much buy in this game.
Well,
the fact that Maokai or Galio doesn't have it makes the damage so much harder to be put out from the side of TWT. Because it gives you an aura that lowers the MR on the other team, and it gives you more MR than Visage anyway.
I agree. I also just don't think that the Stormraiser here is extremely needed by Caitlyn.
It's kind of an outdated build. Most people that I've been seeing have been going, like, Divinity Edge. We're talking about that. Another engage. Later on. Keeps wanting to bring this team back into this fight. Leona and Zac are in the front lines. They've got the engage. Rakan has been taken super low. One Murata will take him down. Rakan is taken down, but now look how low everyone is from the side of TWT.
Oh,
they're trying to kite back. Caitlyn's full health. Caitlyn needs to get these auto attacks in. OJ Juice Man is dubbing in again. Caitlyn is just walking away in the fear of this Vladimir. The Vladimir is huge. 170 CS and two items now. They have a perfect engage. They actually end up killing the support instantly, but they just can't get the damage down to get Vlad. And Vlad has a free reign of this game right now.
Vlad
is towered
with
the people. Beautiful
God.
Flash attack from Caitlyn, and now there's no damage really from the side of TWT. Vlad is going to pull one more Q, will take down Zac. And Zac just jumps to his own death right there. It's just. Vlad is in your base, just stomping on your teammates. There's nothing you can do about
it. He's in your base, killing your dudes. He's, he's absolutely massive. I mean, and this is why Vladimir makes me drink, you know?
Yes.
You look at this champ who has tower immunity. Tons of damage, tons of healing. He's just so strong.
Well, we knew Skips would play one of these scaling mid laners that he likes playing so much coming as an AD carry main. It's just paying off in dividends for him.
Well, and that phase rush, too. I mean, you saw how he used it really well, closing the distance.
Just so easily ran him down.
Yeah, he just ran him down, killed the Caitlyn in like two hits, even though she was doing pretty well. Well,
yeah, could you just show the stream, hit Z real quick, and show them the gold difference in the solo lanes right now? It's insane.
Oh, Z does not do that for me. X.
You might if I could do something else. Yeah, I made it Z.
Yeah, so looking at the solo lane gold difference, obviously we got 11k in the top lane versus 6k, almost 7. So that's pretty insane. Jungle difference is huge. Mid difference, I mean, like, everywhere on the map you can kind of see it. But mainly in that top lane, man. The top and mid. I mean, top mid jungle, that top side's like, they're each three or 4k ahead.
Yeah, like, I know that he just flame horized him in the top lane, 222 to 122, but is there a gold horizon? Like,
yeah,
he almost has
horizon.
Double his gold. Like, that is insane.
Yeah, it's really crazy. He's, like, Eric's so fed. It feels good to be a fed Ornn, to be honest.
It's just going to be on all the time, but it's just,
like,
we see time and time again, TWT, they're trying to just hold on to any victory they can. They're diving hard for the Sivir, and they're really forcing Maokai to come mid over and over as Ornn just keeps collecting these side waves, and it's just really crippling him right now.
Yeah, I mean, OG Juzman is just letting him push in. He's full health. This is the summary of the game. Ornn is still full health.
Yeah, there's nothing he can do about
There's nothing you can do. Dude's fed. He's 5-0. He has two Ornn items.
Yeah, look, here comes the Ornn ult as well. The Nullify is coming up mid. There's no tower this time to save them. Reckless Flash is actually in place. I think he got a little miscue there. It's instantly burst down by them. Yeah, Jonas gets to kill Murphy Rotted, but only the support is going down. Everyone else is super juicy right now. They try to find. Sivir is just beating down Insta Boy. Insta Boy got on Sivir right there, but none of his team could follow it up. Yeah, it's just going to be a quick GG, yeah. I think.
Let me tell you about that fight. Ornn is still full health.
Yes. Well, everyone is on full health. Look at that. Sejuani's full health. Sivir. Well, this is an AD carry in Season 10. Sivir almost died 1v1 to Leona there, but still doesn't matter.
Right, it doesn't matter. Like, it's just like, here's the thing. Your Ornn has like 8 billion K health. He has a bunch of armor, so your only damage source isn't doing anything. You don't have percent max health on your AP. And it's GG, dude.
Yeah, it's a super clean victory there, about 26 minutes on the dot. 13,000 gold advantage, 25-10 in the favor of IRS.
Yeah, I mean, absolutely massive win. IRS just, like, showing off, like, I am a tank top laner, and I will just smack you into the dirt. Mm. So I think TWT, I think they should be start looking at some of the bruisers that counter these tanks in the 1v1 and focus more on that 1v1 in the top lane. They might have a better option after pick ban, as well as maybe picking up some percent health damage in the AD carry role. Like going with the Stormraiser there, it helps a lot in lane and for kiting. But I feel like, you know, if you are playing against what you see there, you know, you got to build IE or maybe even Blade of the Rune King. Those things can help you in terms of dealing with these giant tanks. I mean, Blade of the Rune King, obviously not a great item on Caitlyn, but sometimes you're forced to do what the game forces you to do. Well-played game from IRS. Just a big leads generated on the top side of the map, securing them that W. So let's take a look now at the stats. Here we go. Game is still in progress. We all know that's a lie, League of Legends.
Yeah, super lie. But really, I think, as you're saying, prioritizing tanks for game two, you've got to ban Sejuani against Neil the Steel, I think. Just such a comfort pick for him. It was very silly, I think, not to ban it.
I feel like they're worried a little too much about just what their bot lane is going to do with Reckless and Tizzy Boy. Whereas, like, if you ban out, you know, if you ban Ornn Sej, I think you're going to be doing a lot better. And putting Murphy on maybe something he's a little bit more comfortable on than the Rakan. Because I saw a couple plays there, but it didn't look like the most comfortable thing. Like, I feel like Murphy is a good player on just a little bit more damage than what Rakan can do. So I'd like to see a little bit more damage from the support role. Maybe some percent health ADs. So, like, Kog'Maw or Ezreal. Who builds
someone's asking for the damage chart before we cut the vod and go to game two.
Yeah, so the damage chart here, we see Vladimir. We see all these tanks dealing way too much damage for a tank roll, almost equaling their AD carry, which is not how League of Legends was designed, but it is how it is now right now. So, I mean, overall, though, the Galio did really good damage. It's just the Caitlyn had a hard time, it looks like, just getting protected enough against Ornn Sej, Vlad, Rakan. Just a very hard team comp to play Caitlyn into. So that's what we're seeing. So I guess now, StarCraft, are you setting up the MVP vote for game one?
Yeah, I already put in the chat
ahead
of you.
All right. Well,
yeah, now, as I predicted, Neil's just flying away with it. Really, that counter gank mid that got Vlad the kill, almost a double kill on Vlad.
That was huge. I mean, honestly,
it really accelerated the whole game because of Vlad up 400 gold. You're not looking back. Like you're screwed.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was a close game in the beginning there. I mean, once Tizzy Boy came up to mid and did that roam, I thought it could go either way. But the tankiness, the champions they had, Neil of Steel doing a great job getting the CC down in team fights as well as in the early game, just controlling the gank and the pacing. I mean, it was obviously really huge. So, all right, we're going to cut stream for now so I can fix up my red and blue sides and we can have the good VODs. And I will see you in a little bit. Thanks, everyone.